Don't care where you come from, as long as you're a black man.
In 1977, reggae legend Peter Tosh released the song Equal Rights, demanding freedom for a number of African nations, but he also mentioned another country. When George Jackson, a Black Panther, writer, and revolutionary, was killed by prison guards in 1971, two poems were found in his cell. They were translations of resistance poetry by the Palestinian poet Sami al-Kazim. Peter Tosh and George Jackson's connection to Palestine are just two examples of a long history of solidarity between Black liberation and Palestinian self-determination, two struggles that have been in dialogue for decades. In 1964, Malcolm X published an article in the Egyptian Gazette called Zionist Logic, in which he drew parallels between the oppression of Palestinians and Africans. Instead of seeing it as a religious conflict, Malcolm saw Israel as a colonial project serving a wider imperialist agenda, saying, "European imperialists wisely placed Israel where she could geographically divide the Arab world." In the same year, Malcolm was one of the first African leaders to publicly meet with the Palestine Liberation Organization, as anti-colonial struggles gained traction through the world. Freedom for Palestinians became a touchstone for the international fight against imperialism. As Black freedom movements expanded their worldview to situate their struggle as part of a global anti-colonial movement, Palestine also became an important focal point of their solidarity. On August 15, 1967, the Student Nonviolent Coordinating Committee released a position paper entitled The Middle East Crisis, expressing support for Palestine and criticizing US support for Israel. Organizations such as the Black Panthers argued that freedom would never come for Black people in America unless all oppressed people were free. The Panthers frequently spoke of Black communities and their relationship with police as living under occupation as internally colonized people. They were vocal in their support for Palestine and met with the PLO in Algiers in 1969. In his 1972 essay, Take Me to the Water, James Baldwin wrote about leaving the US but refusing to go live in Israel, saying, "And if I had fled to Israel, a state created for the purpose of protecting Western interests, I would have been in a yet tighter bind. On which side of Jerusalem would I have decided to live?" Muhammad Ali also declared his support for the Palestinian struggle, marching for Palestinian rights and visiting a Palestinian refugee camp in southern Lebanon. In 1979, Reverend Jesse Jackson met with the PLO and pushed for the US to deal directly with the organization in pursuit of a peace deal.
"Just and lasting peace is inextricably bound for a state for Palestinian people and the recognition of the PLO as the government in exile with which our nation must negotiate."
This was a significant shift in support for Palestine, moving from radical groups to more mainstream figures who were able to lobby for shifts in US policy. 10 years later, Jackson would find himself in an audience in Harlem as Nelson Mandela addressed a packed town hall.
"As far as Yasser Arafat is concerned, I explained to Mr. Sidney that we identify with the PLO because just like ourselves, they are fighting for the right of self-determination."
Like Mandela, Archbishop Desmond Tutu drew global attention to the plight of Palestinians as being parallel to that of Black South Africans under apartheid.
"The inhumanity that won't let ambulances reach the injured, farmers tend their land, or children attend school. This treatment is familiar to me and the many Black South Africans who were corralled and harassed by the security forces of the apartheid government."
Mandela made a historic trip to Palestine in 1999.
"Choose peace rather than confrontation, except in cases where we cannot get, where we cannot proceed, where we cannot move forward. Then, if the only alternative is violence, we will use violence."
A statue of Mandela stands in the occupied West Bank city of Ramallah, a gift from South Africa to the people of Palestine. His grandson, Mandla Mandela, continues to be an outspoken critic of Israel.
Release all political prisoners. We want to say to the Israeli government today that give the 6 million Palestinians living in exile their right of return.
It's not possible to talk about global black solidarity for Palestine without discussing black Palestinians or Afro-Palestinians themselves. Some Afro-Palestinians trace their roots to the land as far back as the 12th century and are descendants of Muslim pilgrims who went to Mecca for Hajj and then settled in Jerusalem. Others are the descendants of those who migrated from places such as Nigeria, Sudan, Senegal, and Chad. Some of them came to Palestine specifically to fight against British colonialism and Zionism.
The second, third, fourth generation, if you ask us to identify ourselves, we say we are Afro-Palestinians. We born here, we grew up here.
The community is deeply rooted in Jerusalem, with a long history of involvement in the Palestinian Liberation Movement. Ali Jidda is a leader of Jerusalem's Afro-Palestinian community, who served 17 years in Israeli prisons as a member of the Popular Front for the Liberation of Palestine.
The African community used to be always among the avant-garde. For example, the first Palestinian female to be put in Israeli jails came from the African Quarter.
This was Fatima Bernawi, a Palestinian of Nigerian descent who served 10 years in Israeli prisons. Released in a 1977 prisoner exchange, she was the highest-ranking female member of Fatah. The first Palestinian killed during the Second Intifada in 2000 was Osama Jidda, an Afro-Palestinian shot on his way to donate blood.
Journal of the hard times, tales from the dark side, evidence of the settlements on my hard drive. Man, I swear my heart died at the end of that car ride. When I saw that checkpoint, welcome to apartheid.
Hip-hop artists have also referenced and stood in solidarity with the Palestinian struggle, including Lauryn Hill, who famously cancelled a Tel Aviv concert in 2015.
And Martin Luther King had a dream of the checkpoint. He wake with loud screams from the scenes at the checkpoint. Is Malcolm X by any means at the checkpoint? Imagine if your daily routine was the checkpoint.
Meanwhile, hi, that's M1 in Arabic. I'm pro-Palestinian, does that make me a terrorist? You can catch me in Gaza, in Haifa or Ramallah, but I'm still just Mutulu Olubala. So when I rep the Shaja, we rhyme with our middle fingers up to the Zionists, cause we don't give a f- It's justice.
You can't trust the big grip and the smile, and I slay rhymes for Palestinians.
It's mathematics when they take a black man, put him inside a prison, and make provisions for the life he living. It's mathematics when they tell the Mexican he can't come into their own shit that these people f***ing built. It's mathematics when they go to Palestine and build a wall around the people and call it Israel. Now what's real?
Speaking of America, state and the president, with all due respect, I've got something to say to them. I just find it funny you can't give a hand to Palestine, but you can trade whole arms with Saudi Arabia.
Should I'm way past the minimum, interim millennium, harass the holy Gathia back like Palestinians.
And this is struggle worldwide, I'm positive. Shit, the ghetto minds love me, the Gaza Strip.
Same for my father, born in Ghana, down on that dirt road floor. Far as he came, I can't complain, but pain is so subjective. Spent so much time counting issues, I forget to count my blessings.
This video for Vic Mensa's single, We Could Be Free, illustrates the clear parallels between life under Israeli occupation and life in over-policed black communities in the US. Following the death of Freddie Gray at the hands of police in Baltimore in 2014, uprisings began around the US. And as police reprisals escalated in Ferguson, Palestinians took to social media to show solidarity with black communities as well as sharing protest tactics.
And we started getting tweets from Ramallah, and they were like, run toward the wind. You know, stand closer to the soldiers, because if you stand close to the soldiers, they won't tear gas you, because then they'd get tear gassed. Yeah. You know, wrap this shirt around your eyes as a kind of makeshift gas mask. And they had been protesting in the West Bank against what was happening in Gaza.
Many have also drawn attention to the cooperation and joint programs run between the Israeli military and U.S. police forces.
I remember learning that the same equipment that they use to brutalize us is the same equipment that we send to the Israeli military to police and brutalize Palestinians.
Like the Black Panthers, groups like the Dream Defenders and Black Lives Matter continue to push for solidarity with Palestine within an internationalist framework. When Israel attacked Lebanon in 2006, renowned writer Toni Morrison signed a statement with other public intellectuals, saying the attacks were a distraction in order to divert world attention from a long-term military, economic, and geographic practice whose political aim is nothing less than the liquidation of the Palestinian nation. Mark Lamont Hill was famously fired from CNN for saying this at a United Nations function.
Local action, an international action that will give us what justice requires. And that is a free Palestine from the river to the sea.
Dr. Cornel West also claims that his vocal opposition to Israeli occupation may have led to him being denied tenure at Harvard. But the sacrifice of black radicals, scholars, and intellectuals in shifting public attitudes on Palestine has not been in vain. Mainstream solidarity with Palestinians is clearly growing in Western countries. In 2021, Ilhan Omar, Ayanna Pressley, Cori Bush, and others all expressed unwavering support for Palestine during Israel's attacks on Gaza. An unprecedented show of solidarity in the history of US Congress.
That means we oppose our money going to fund militarized policing, occupation, and systems of violent oppression and trauma. We are anti-war, we are anti-occupation, and we are anti-apartheid, period.